Time now for the Media Monitor, our weekly look at the hits and errors in the news business. Brian Williams gave it his best shot, but his news magazine just couldn't get much traction. NBC canceled Rock Center on Friday, a year and a half after its debut. Now, Rock Center did some very solid journalism by the likes of Ted Koppel and Richard Engel, but there were also weak feature segments and a clouded identity. And by the way, the network changed the time slot so many times, even I couldn't remember when it was on. Bloomberg News is admitting that its reporters use the company's financial data terminals, which clients pay big bucks to use, to snoop on how often Wall Street executives logged on and what categories of information they looked at. Now, the spying, according to CNBC, even extended to such top government officials as Ben Bernanke and Tim Geithner, an incredible breach of the wall between the company's financial side and its worldwide news organization. That story is not over. Finally, the man known as the Fox Mole paid a price in court this week. Joe Muto, a Fox News producer who was fired after writing stories anonymously for the website Gawker, was escorted into the courtroom in handcuffs. He pleaded guilty to two misdemeanors, was fined $1,000, must donate the $5,000 he received from Gawker, and perform substantial community service. Fox was right, it turns out. This particular mole broke the law.